room for that red, and he has slammed it in. What a pot. And that makes the black frame ball. It's a crushing blow for Ryan Day, because he must have thought from Marco Fu's demeanour that it was end of break there, but he could get through to the red, and he absolutely slammed it in. 56 the lead, 59 on the table. This the 5-3 barring snookers. That's why there were no heroics, just pop the black. One snooker to tie. Over 60, includes two centuries, 84. And this, all of the result of Ryan Day going for that very risky red from left centre. It looks a little bit reckless, that one. It looks like it's cost him the frame. Side of this, he's turned it over, and all Fu has to do is roll this red in, and that is in the frame. A disappointing frame for Ryan Day, having done well to win the seventh, get back in the match. The mistakes in this one have proved very expensive. Ryan Day will come back. He's thinking about it. He has decided. He will have a go. It's highly unlikely he's going to turn things around here. Here with four snookers required, but good shot necessary to get out of the first one. Well played. But as I say, with the blue where it is and the green and brown as well, it's worth Ryan Day having a go here for the time being. table, always with the chance of a free ball, which will make life easier. He's played that pretty well, and always trickier when the object ball is close to other balls, because the likelihood of hitting one of those instead is much greater. From Fu, we'll tell him he's 48 in front, 35 on, still three snookers required. Still a very long shot for Ryan Day to turn this around, but he is in control of the table. Who he wants to avoid here at all costs is leaving the free ball. Deliberately missed the red. He doesn't want to pot that, because while it's on the table, the free ball is still a possibility. Played it pretty well, although he might be in trouble after this one. extension. This is a bit of a stretch. Get the object ball safe. For him to lay a snooker this time, though. Pretty good effort, this. Pretty good effort. Well, he'll take that. It's another snooker. Don't think it's too difficult to hit this time, although. Okay. One cushion. Oh, he's missed it! Well, that does change things. Three out of the four snookers. Is it a free ball? Looks like it might be. He'll be able to hit both sides of the red. It must be a free ball, surely. My day saying, of course it is. Way you can hit the. I'm not sure why it took Olivia Marti as long as it did there to board the free ball. It's very obviously a free ball. You've got to be able to hit both edges of the object ball. Now, what you can't do here is snooker behind the free ball, but you can elect a colour as an extra red here and snooker behind one of the other colours. reflection now. The difference, so he can elect the blue ball as the free ball, but snooker behind green and brown. Oh, he's elected to pop the blue, so that counts as one. Incredible. Marco Fu was 100 to 1 on about 10 minutes ago. Now, no more than evens with the position of the colours. There's nothing safe. Two up with three to play. Very strong position. Frame for Fu to lose, and a terrific one for Dave to steal. Not well. Good pace. Cue ball. The red goes to their respective cushions. Is that Ryan Day has been able to keep control of the safety exchange throughout. What Fu has been able to do is try and escape from the snookers, but he's never been in a position to wrest control of the table. There's another one. This is excellent stuff from Ryan Day. Fu is 32 in front, but with the position of the reds, the red I should say, and the colours, I don't think he's the favourite for the frame anymore. At best it's even Stevens, and a snooker, this is difficult. Well, that's even worse. That's even worse. This is extraordinary. What a turnaround here in this eighth frame. It's an absolute certainty that Marco Fu was going to go 5-3 up. Ryan Day needed four snookers. He fought long and hard in his chair before deciding to come back to the table to play for them. I bet he's glad he did now. What a chance this is to pinch a frame. He looked a certainty to lose. Fu has a very placid temperament, it's one of his strengths, but he'll be tested to the full if he loses this frame. Definitely the underdog now. He's close to losing this frame, but Day needs to get good position on the yellow again here. So another good pot required. But if this goes as it should, it's a great chance to steal. Frames of the season so far. Four snookers needed for Ryan Day. Looks as though he's going to win the frame. On the very brink of losing it. Ryan Day than Marco Fu right now. Plenty of pressure on this as well, Ryan Day. But he stood up to the pressure. This relatively simple black will win him a frame and no right to win. That is a quite incredible frame in this second semi-final. Ryan Day needed 1, 2, 3, 4 snookers. He got them with the help of a free ball, and he's cleared up to steal a frame. He looked certain to lose on the black, and it's honours even at 4 frames all.